Now, the western part of our state got slammed first by these powerful winds that we're seeing here, and there is considerable damage there.
At this point, no reports of tornado touchdowns in Wisconsin, as was initially feared. But Andrea, we do have wind damage to talk about, and I suppose the possibility that in daylight we could identify some spots that were hit by tornadoes.
Absolutely. It's considerable damage. We're going to look first at the town of Stanley, which is near Chippewa Falls. And honestly, when you look at the damage here, you're going to see it looks very similar to what a tornado can do. But of course, until people from the National Weather Service can get to Stanley and do a survey, we won't know for sure. But this is what it looks like right now in Stanley, Wisconsin, which is along Highway 29 on the western side of the state. Overnight, dozens of crews were seen responding in the downtown area. The town's main drag, Broadway Street, has been shut down for several blocks as crews are trying to understand the extent of the damage. There are reports of downed trees and power lines. Buildings have been damaged. You see them here, shingles and debris all across the streets. Thankfully, no injuries have been reported, but this cleanup is going to be immense. Bill Koala says his business has been left in shambles.
We got a phone call about 10 to 10, said that our offices were gone, our office and warehouses. And one of the trailers was moved, so where we're going to start an office tomorrow morning, I have no idea.
And we will be continuing to monitor the situation in western Wisconsin and, of course, learn more about the extent of the damage once the sun comes up. Again, no injuries reported in the Stanley area at this point. We do have some new information. We know school has been canceled today in the Stanley Boyd School District. Aside from the damage, this could be a major reason why the Stanley Police Department says 75% of people in town are without power morning. Yeah.
That's a lot of people. Are we learning anything else from the police there? I mean, I'm sure they're very busy right now, but anything else they're sharing with us?
Yeah, so they're busy. They're out looking at the damage, and they know that when daylight arrives, they're going to see a lot more of that damage. They want people to stay home and not go out and be tempted to look at the destruction because there are power lines down across the town, and they don't want anyone to get hurt.
All right, Andrea is going to continue to monitor those reports coming from the other side of the state right now. Appreciate that, Andrea.